faith, also Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed and was delivered of a child when she was past age.
Read that one more time.
Through faith.
Through what?
Through faith.
Read on.
Also, Sarah herself received strength to conceive seed. Well,
received strength because she was past the age. The age where women have children. Do everybody understand that? But she received strength in believing what God had told her. Do everybody understand that? To be able to conceive seed. Everybody got that? Read on.
And was delivered of a child when she was past age.
Read on.
Because she judged
because
him.
Because she did what?
She judged him.
Read on.
Faithful.
Read on.
Who had promised.
Because she did what? She believed God. She believed God. If she didn't believe him, then it would have been a sin. Everybody understand that? Everybody got that? But she believed God. You got a lot of sisters that want to have children and feel that something is blocking them from having children. Do you believe God? Then if you believe God, then you should know that you're going to have children. Who is the one that stated that Abraham's seed should become as the stars of heaven? Who?
Christ.
Who said it?
Christ.
Who said it?
Christ.
You know who said it. You don't believe him? Then what did the Bible say? The Bible said what? That the woman should be the woman. Oh, I'm telling you, these thoughts is amazing. The Bible says that Eve should be called woman, right? And that name means to be of the earth. She was named after the earth. Okay, so now he gave the woman the name that the earth had. Why did he give the woman the name that the earth have? Because from that point, people wasn't going to no longer be coming from the earth. They was going to start to come from the woman, right? Because she would now be the mother of all living, right? So I'm just connecting it for you guys. If the Lord said that the seed of the nation of Israel shall be as the stars of heaven, then that means these babies got to come through who? They're going to come from the earth? Where are they going to come from? They're going to come through the women. Now, if you are Israelite women and you the daughters of Abraham and Sarah, then that means you are the ones that's going to inherit the promise to be what? Fruitful and multiply. The Lord looked at Sarah, and I don't think I'm going to get the quote correctly, but I think he told her to be thou the mother of millions. Is that what he said? Let me get that scripture. Give me that scripture. So it shouldn't be, listen, you up there, my clock is ticking. You ain't got no clock. You don't. Your clock is done. Your clock is ticking. Let's look at Genesis 17:16. That's what the Lord said. That's not what I'm looking for. Y'all hear my quote? 24, the chapter 24. Let's look at the chapter 24. In what verse? 60. Right, that's it. Yeah, see, I shortchanged it. That's how you got to get the scriptures. Millions wasn't enough, bro. And it was Rebecca. Okay, let's look at this. Give me Genesis chapter 24. And 59. Let's start there.
And they
actually start at verse 58. Showing you that the blessings carry on. Everybody understand that? The blessings carry on. Actually, get Genesis chapter 17. Let's look at that. Hold that, because the Spirit brought us there, so let's look at that. Genesis chapter 17, verse 15. To show us that the blessings go all the way down. It just don't stop with who it was told to, but is also inherited. Genesis chapter 17, verse 15. Read that.
And God said unto Abraham,
read on.
As for Sarai, thy wife, thou shalt not call her Sarai, but Sarah shall her name be.
Read on.
And I will bless her.
Read on.
And give thee a son also of her.
Read on.
Yea, I will bless her.
Read on.
And she shall be a mother.
She shall be what?
A mother.
She shall be what?
A mother.
Read on.
Of nations.
That's a whole lot of children. Everybody understand that? So, you know, all the nations wasn't going to come through her, was it? No, it wasn't all going to come through her, but it was going to come through her children. Them children was going to be multiplying. It was going to come through her daughters. where was it going to come to? Be fruitful and what? Multiply. Everybody got that, right? Read on.
Kings of people shall be of her.
Now let's go to Genesis chapter 24. Genesis chapter 24. The problem is weak faith. It's weak faith. You know, just believe. Believe in what God has said. Know that it's going to happen. When you operate in that way, it's inevitable. Everybody understand that? The scripture says it's impossible for God to lie. Right? So you know that he's telling you the truth. Right? Okay, come on. Genesis chapter 24. And what verse was that? Let's read verse 58. Genesis chapter 24, verse 58. Read that.
And they called Rebekah and said unto her,
read on.
Wilt thou go with this man?
Read it one more time.
Wilt thou go with this man?
Read on.
And she said,
read on.
I will go.
Okay, the righteous order coming together. An Israelite man and an Israelite woman. Israelite men and women is going to fulfill the Israelite promise. Everybody got that, right? What is the Israelite promise? I don't hear you guys. Now, that's the promise of all nations on the planet Earth. But what is the Israelite promise? For our nation to become as the stars of heaven, which cannot be what? Thank you. That's the Israelite promise. So Israelite men, once you come together, that's what's going to eventually happen. You're going to be doing your part. You think it's going to happen by one or two sisters? That's how y'all think the multitudes of the stars of heaven is coming through? Huh? And coming forth? And we ain't done. Y'all think we done? Y'all think we done? Y'all think the nation of Israel already became as the stars of heaven? Nah, they haven't. They haven't. They haven't. They could be counted. They can still be counted. They can still be counted. I'm going to tell you something. The scripture says that when we get into the kingdom of Christ, that a small one should become a nation. That's talking about in the kingdom of Christ. So the process of fulfilling that promise is still not fulfilled. The scriptures tell you when Christ returned and it was time for all things to be done, that they seen what was standing before the Lamb, which was what? Which was what? A multitude of nations which cannot be measured nor numbered. Everybody understand that? Everybody got that? Which cannot be measured nor numbered in the book of Revelation chapter 7. We didn't get to that process yet. And these are they which have made themselves white in the blood of the Lamb. So that's letting you know that that's all throughout that process of that 1,000 years when we're going to multiply as the stars of heaven. When he come back in his second coming, Israel still ain't going to make themselves right. Why you think you spending 1,000 years with Christ? Is at the end of that 1,000 years. And that's when the promise is going to be fulfilled. So the multiplying is still going to be increased. Why do you think the Lord leaving you in the flesh? Right? I'm going to miss out. You ain't missing out on nothing.